Hello viewers, in this video we will see how to edit a public domain work. Let's go. Welcome to Tech Library TV, and in case if this is the first time you're visiting the channel, my name is Arun and I'm so happy that you're here. You can follow me on Twitter using the handle given on the screen now, and you can also find the Facebook page for Tech Library TV, which is given in the show notes below. Let's start by seeing some ground rules while publishing a public domain book. To publish a public domain book, we have to differentiate a book. If illustrating, we must have 10 or more unique illustrations that are relevant to the book. We'll see what these terms mean in a few minutes. Titles must be changed to show translated, annotated, or illustrated. You have to declare that you are using a public domain book in the ebook details or the content page. There are some actions which are not considered as differentiations, like it could be a linked table of contents, formatting improvements, or any articles that are freely available on the internet, perhaps from you. We just cannot pick content from, say, Wikipedia or any other blog and then copy and paste and show that as if it's our book. So that's not allowed. And also just remember to keep the original author name and put your name as the translator option. As in here, the original author name should be under the author name here. And then you can add your name as the under the contributor section, as you can see here, while adding your ebook details. Let's now get into the details. There are three options that KDP provides us with to differentiate a book, which are illustrate, annotate, and translate when it comes to publishing books that are in the public domain. The most common ones among these three are illustrating and translating options, while annotation is quite ambiguous to explain if you ask me. Even Amazon doesn't have a distinguishing metric to show that a book is annotated, as you can see that in the drop-down we don't have a separate annotated option to select. We have translator option and the illustrator option, and there are some other options over here that could possibly mean annotation, like editing for example, but we don't want to work on guesses here, as that has the risk of disqualifying the book while publishing it. Keep watching the video till the end and we'll see a suitable example to learn more about annotations. So by the end of this video, you might get a good idea about what annotation really means. Okay, so before we get into the details on how to do these, let's first see what these exactly mean. Say illustrate. Here's the dictionary definition. Illustrate means a picture illustrating a book, a newspaper, etc. So simply put, it means to provide a book with pictures. Or explain or make something clear by using examples, charts, pictures, etc. So this brings us to the next logical question of how to illustrate a book. We again have three options here. Create our own illustrations using a software, or hire a friend or a virtual assistant to create illustrations, or use CC0, which is no copyright public domain images. But just a warning here, this is a risky option. Let's now see all these three in detail. Number one, create our own illustrations using a software. Inkscape is a free, open source software that we can use to create our own illustrations to be added to the book. There are plenty of video tutorials available over here that can help you learn how to create your own illustrations. It might take a week or so to get used to the software and become proficient in, but with practice, you can start creating your own original illustrations to add to any book. This is the best way to illustrate a book. Here's a pro tip. This option over here has a community created Inkscape media that are in public domain, which can be downloaded. You can go into community and then gallery, and then search media category by all, or choose whatever options you want and choose public domain over here. Number two, hire a friend or a virtual assistant to create illustrations. The second option is to hire a friend or remote assistants and pay $5 to create illustrations. Sites like Fiverr can help you with that. This ensures you can have original illustrations for your book without any further worry. You just have to explain them what you want, pay them their fee, and you get your high quality illustration done. Here's an example from the Fiverr website where this person offers to create a children's book illustration, as you can see here, and for $5 you can get 1 day delivery with 4 revisions and a black and white, which is just a black and white sketch, and you also get the source file along with it. There are plenty of options similar to this that you can find on Fiverr website. The last option is using images from Pixabay or Unsplash, for example, that offers copyright free public domain images, where you can find suitable illustrations, drawings to add to your book. Here's an example from Pixabay I found, which has a CC0 Creative Commons license, which is free for commercial use, and there's no attribution required. Of course, they will appreciate if you can provide a link back, but then it is not required. But there's a word of caution here. This might not always work, as Amazon says, as you can see here, freely available internet content is also not allowed. But yeah, you have this option with that risk though. And a bonus tip here, learning to use at least one of these three software can help us in the long run. Photoshop, GIMP, Inkscape. These are all graphics programs that can tremendously help in creating our own drawings and artwork. Learning these might take time, but it's worth the efforts. If you cannot get Photoshop, GIMP is an alternative open source and free to download program similar to Inkscape. Learning even just one of these programs is enough, and others are quite similar. In fact, just learn to use brushes, layers, and color picking tools, and basically you can ignore all the other features which might seem intimidating for a beginner. That alone can make you cross 50% of the ocean. If you're hungry for more, here's a list of 35 free graphics programs that are free alternatives to other paid softwares. Now let's see the other option, Translate. This is a simple and straightforward option. If you are well versed in writing and speaking in English and any one other language, which could be your native mother tongue, a foreign language, or any other regional language, then you can translate a public domain book into that other language which you are confident in using. Then publish it through KDP. This is a time-consuming task, but it's simple and straightforward. In this webpage from Amazon help topic page, there are some translation resources which are primarily for people who are authors who are looking for translators to help them out. But then you can still use some of the resources mentioned here, like from some of the questions that you might ask yourself before you get into translation work. For example, how long will the translation take? How much the translation might cost? You could do some research and then find out for your own as to how much this could how much of efforts this might take for you to pick up before you get into the translation task. The next option is about annotation. Annotate. KDP Help Topic says annotations are like additional content, like study guides, literary critiques, detailed biographies, or historical context. To better understand this, let's see a successful example from Amazon itself. As you can see, they can have a example on the Amazon topic itself, Pride and Prejudice Annotated, which I'm going to search, and I already have it open over here, and let's go into this particular option. As you can see, they have clearly given what extra features they added to this book to differentiate it. This annotated edition of one of the most beloved novels in the world is a sheer delight for Jane Austen fans. He's going to with more than 2,300 annotations on facing pages, including explanations of historical context, citations and other writings, definitions, clarifications, literary comments, analysis, maps, illustrations, introduction, bibliography, detailed chronology of events. They have given a tremendous value to this book, Pride and Prejudice, which is a quite famous book. and this person has picked up this book and then added a lot of details that could add value to the readers. This can show us how annotations can be successfully implemented. So this can be a classic example. This person David Shepard has also given another a similar book from the same author Jane Austen here, Sense and Sensibility. Let's see how the customer reviews have turned up. This book also has 2000 annotations on facing pages, including explanations of historical context, citations, definitions, clarifications, literary comments, analysis, introduction, everything. More than 100 informative illustrations. Although you may not give so much, you could at least at a minimum should give 10 or more unique illustrations that are relevant to the book. Let us see the comments as for this particular book as to how it has been given. As you can see, there are so many good comments. To tell the truth, I love his annotations. There's so much dimension to my favorite stories. The annotated version of yours, wow. Makes sense. Similar to the other Shepherd versions of his novels, plenty of useful notes, drawings, explanations, etc. The notes are worthwhile. I have a richer understanding of this novel because of these annotations and notes. Many of the notes provide historical context and differences is available to me. So these are some of the helpful comments, because this author has really added value to this book by providing his own additions on top of the original public domain book. Now let us get inside the book and see some examples. So here's a copyright page, and these are the table of contents. See, these are the illustrations that got added to this book. Let's see what they are. There are so much of illustrations that the person has added to the original book. These are all illustrations, like a drawing or writing table, and so much. Let's see the first pages. This is first page. Let us try and find out if there's any image added. It'll come from the front cover. There you go. Here is an image. Did we find that on the illustrations table of contents? A woman with a book outdoors, front page. Yep, that's there. Here it is. A woman reading a book outdoors. So this is an illustration added by our author. I think so, because if you can see, there is a reference to this original source of this image. Perhaps this is a public domain image which this author has, this contributor has added as part of the illustration. As you can see, it's written as from the repository of arts, literature, fashions, manufacturers, whatever. And then there's an year which gives as 1815 or 1318 or something, which is clearly in the public domain. So this young woman reading book, this illustration is added to this book. Similarly, there are so illustrations, as you can see, that got added to the book. Apart from that, let's also check the surprise me section, which may or may not give us more images. As an example, okay, I'm not going to waste much more time on this. You can check it for yourself if you get an option to do so by verifying. See, there are some more books over here, the Annotated Persuasion, the Annotated Emma. These are all quite famous books that got annotated. What's good is that the comment section, as you can see, this is the kind of experience that we want our readers to get when they see a public domain work, that you have added value using illustrations or translations with so much value added. that can benefit your readers and than just simply throwing in few random images and publishing it for money. I hope this video helped in understanding better about editing public domain books. Please hit on the like button if it did, and subscribe if you haven't already done so, because I will soon be doing another detailed video on how to find public domain books, how to validate and confirm the book is in public domain, and how to insert your annotations, illustrations into the public domain books, and much more. Thanks for watching.